friends. I'm making a special dinner right now, and I thought I might do some a video of the cooking sounds. So I'm gonna try to make nice sounds and not too loud. Right now I'm making a vegan cheese. So I've got boiling. I've got some potatoes and carrots. And I'm waiting for them to get soft, and then I'm going to blend it with a bunch of ingredients, and I'll show you what I'm doing. So I've got 2 cups of potatoes and 1 cup of carrots, and it's chopped up, and I'm boiling it. It's probably got... Oh, it's almost ready. I'm going to boil it for like 2 more minutes. I'm also working on a salsa, so I've got onions and tomatoes chopped up right now, and I'm chopping up more tomatoes. I'm making a lot. I'm making it for some people who are coming through who are playing tonight, so I gotta make sure I make enough for them, and I think it's 5 people, but possibly more, so I want everyone to be fed. So I'm also cooking some chili over here. You can't really see that from that, but it's been slow cooking for several hours now, so it's getting close to ready. It's got lots of vegetables and lots of beans in it. Drain these and let them cool for a little bit while I finish chopping these tomatoes, I guess. Well, maybe I should make this room. It doesn't really matter. I'll just finish chopping. This is the 3rd tomato. I think I'll start with 4 tomatoes and see how that is. I want it to be a lot of tomatoes because it's a salsa, but I'm kind of making this up as I go. Like a basic recipe that I've made before that works well. It's just tomatoes, red onion, green pepper, and jalapeno, and lime juice, and salt. I think that's all. And that is a nice, fresh salsa that is nothing too complex. And I like to blend it a little bit with like a hand blender so it gets like slightly pureed but still chunky. But that is just a matter of opinion. I try to chop it pretty small. I mean, if you want, you don't even have to blend it. You could just eat it like chunky, like just pure chunks. But so loud today, let me tell you what. Been having weird dreams. Been pretty stressed out for a while, so it's nice to have this time to myself before tonight, because tonight is going to be really busy. I'm bartending, and it's going to be a busy show, which is great. I'm really happy about that, but it also is going to be exhausting, probably, so it's good to get some time to rest before that. I find cooking to be relaxing when I have the time for it, and yeah, if I'm just really quickly trying to cook, then it's just sort of a chore, something that needs to be done. But if I have the time to really like enjoy it, then I find it to be fun and relaxing. Let me just make sure this is still recording. Okay, good. Alright. So I've got like 13 minutes left on this. Well, I don't think it's gonna take longer than that. I'm gonna do one green pepper. And I think that should be enough because I have so much. Well, maybe I should start with just one. I don't want to make it too spicy because I don't know, like, I'll start with olive and then I'll see. Because I'm going to put some red chili like sauce in it too. I have chili pepper sauce, which, yeah, it smells good. I think it's like a little bit smoky. I just have to make sure, oh no, I shouldn't use this one because there's some severe allergies. I don't want to risk cross contamination. I'm gonna do both. It'll be okay. There's so much other stuff in here that's not spicy. It'll be fine. And I'm cutting the seeds out so that it's not super spicy also. Again. Okay, I'm gonna start with half of the red pepper. I really don't want to make it too spicy because I want this to be something that everybody can eat. And like a little bit of spice is necessary, but not too much. It's gonna be delicious. It's gonna be like just fresh and simple. I'm excited about it. And you can bet your bottom that I'm gonna have a couple bites before I give it to them. make sure I wash my hands real well before I do anything, because I've got like hot pepper all over them, but I'm not going to do it quite yet, because I'm still messy. Small lime, so I'm using the whole thing, but if you've got like a really big juicy lime, you might want to start with half and then see. Okay. I'm gonna put salt. Start with 1 teaspoon. I'm gonna put from there. I don't think I measured it last time. I think I just put on like Now I'm going to blend this. Well, I'm going to wait to blend it. Because I don't think the blending sound will sound nice. So I'm going to blend it. But I'll show you what it looks like when it's done. Okay, so I'm going to blend the salsa in a little bit. But first I'm going to make the rest of the cheese. So I'm going to show you. And then I'll blend both of them and then show you the finished product. So, yeah. For the cheese, I've got those potatoes and carrots from before, so I'm going to put those in the blender. And they've cooled down a little bit, which is good. I'm gonna put like boiling hot things in your blender. Alright, and now I'm gonna add. First, I need to add 1/2 cup of water or broth. I like to add broth usually, but I am out of broth and I've not had time to make new broth. So, I'm gonna use water. I usually try to have broth all the time available because I have like a bag of vegetables. And in my freezer, just waiting to be used, but I've been so busy that I've not had time, so we're using water today. But that's okay. It's just a little thing to make it a little bit more flavorful, but not necessary. And then I'm gonna add, oh, so I added 1/2 cup of that, and then 1/3 cup of oil. I like to use olive oil, but you could use whatever oil you want to use, probably. I don't really know. And then I'm gonna do 1/2 cup of nutritional yeast. So this stuff, if you've never heard of it before, is amazing. It's got a lot of B vitamins in it, which are really important if you're vegan. And it's got some protein in it and fiber. I mean, not a lot, but it also adds like a cheesy flavor to things. So since we're making a cheese substitute, we want to add some cheese flavor. So the potatoes and carrots give it like a nice cheesy color, and the oil helps it with the texture. Because we're making like a queso style cheese, so something that's creamy and can be used as like a dip, or can be added to the chili. So yeah, so I'm going to do 1/2 cup of this stuff, and this stuff is expensive, but you can buy it in bulk, and it really is amazing. Like, I would say it's totally worth it. Juice of 1/2 lemon, and this gives it a little bit of tanginess. And I will link to the recipe that this is based off of in the description, because it is not my recipe and I don't want to make it seem like it is. That's it. Yeah. Okay, so I'm gonna blend both this and the salsa, and then we're gonna taste it and adjust seasonings as needed. So I'm gonna turn this off, but I'll be right back. Alright, so I think I might have added too much salt. I think it was supposed to be 1 teaspoon. And I added 2 because it tastes really salty. I make this from memory, and I think I was nervous. So, anyway, it's a little salty. I'm sad about that, and I'm not really sure what to do. I guess I can't really fix it, but unless I make like a whole second batch of it. Which I could do. Oh, it's just a lot of work. No, I think maybe I'll add the juice of the rest of this lemon to see if I can balance it out a little bit. Maybe this is a horrible idea, but I have time. If it is, I have time to make a new batch. I think that helped balance it out a little bit. Yeah, I mean, it's still salty, but it tastes less salty because of the acid. So, okay. Well, I'm reasonably happy with that. So I guess I gotta spoon that out and put it in a bowl. Good. Yeah, put that in here. I'm like running out of things to put things. Running out of places to put things. Stuff is delicious. Thank you. mushrooms. Salsa. Oh, let me cover this first. Is like not the prettiest salsa in the world. The problem is like using the fresh tomatoes, you get sort of this color, which is fine as long as it's delicious, but we will see about that. Honestly, I think that's fine. I don't want to touch it. It's a little crunchy. The tomatoes blend easier than the onions and the peppers. So there's some chunks that I might blend out. I'm not sure how loud this is. Blend it too much, it's gonna just get too pureed. It's fine, don't touch it. But I am gonna eat another chip. It only looks not great, but it tastes delicious. I'm pleased. I can live with that. Alright. Well, I guess I'll cover this one too. We made bacon, nacho cheese, and salsa, and we got some chili coming up. That's a great dinner. I hope you enjoyed this, and I'll be back with another cooking video sometime soon, or whatever video. So yeah, see ya next time.